colleague.
Mr. Sunil Arora, Election Commissioner, Mr. Ashok Lavasa, Election Commissioner, and most of the senior officials of the Commission are present. You have been invited today to share information on elections to Karnataka Assembly. The term of the Legislative Assembly of Karnataka is due to expire on 28th of May 2018, and as per the Constitution and the laws, Commission is required to hold general election to constitute new assembly before the expiry of its term, that is before 28th of May. The total number of assembly constituencies there are 224, out of which 36 are reserved for scheduled castes and 15 are reserved for scheduled tribes. As you know, every year we have summary revision of electoral rolls with reference to 1st of January. In Karnataka, this was carried out with reference to 1st January, and the final publication was done on 28th of February 2018. The number of electors in the draft roll were 4.90 crores. In the final rolls, 4.96 crores. To be exact, 4,96,82,357. Repeat. In the draft roll, 4.90 crores. And in the final roll, 4,96,82,357. As against 4,36,85,000 voters in 2013 election. Out of this, males 2,51,79,219, females 2,44,76,840. And you will be happy to note that elector population ratio in Karnataka is 72, which is very close to whatever is the ratio of population above 18 years to the total population, and even gender ratio is very close. Like census 2011 gender ratio is 973, and in electoral rolls it has come up to 972, so it is very close to the ground reality. As regards electoral rolls, we have photo electoral rolls almost 100%, to be exact 99.47% are photo electoral rolls. Only a few photographs are not available, and electors' photo identity cards have also been issued to 97.46%. However, we also issue photo voter slips 7 days before the day of poll to all the voters so that to facilitate them to come to polling station and vote. This can be used as even identity document. With the photo voter slip, a voter guide will also be given to each family. This will be in Kannada, and whomsoever wants in English will be in English. As regards polling station, in 2013, 52,034 polling stations were there, and now after this final publication and rationalization of polling stations, 56,696 polling stations are there, an increase of almost 9%. This year the theme of Election Commission is accessible elections, and therefore we have a special focus on affording convenient registration and voting to persons with disabilities. With that in view, assured minimum facilities at all polling stations have been reviewed by the Commission in their first visit to the state of Karnataka, and you will be happy to note that this aspect is being taken care of by the local administration on top priority. Then voter facilitation for this, in order to fulfill the statutory requirements under Rule 31 of the Conduct of Elections Rules 1961, and to provide accurate and relevant information for voter awareness and information at each polling station, the Commission has also directed that uniform and standardized voter facilitation posters shall be displayed on all polling stations for greater facilitation. And voter assistance booth will also be set up at every polling station to augment the voter facilitation. Special arrangements are being made for women. In fact, all women managed polling station, including the security, will be 5 in every urban constituency and 1 in every rural constituency. So in all, more than 450 polling stations will be managed by all women. As you all know, that Commission had committed to all parties that along with the electronic voting machines, VVPAT shall be deployed in all future elections. And therefore, in line with that decision, all polling stations will have electronic voting machine and VVPAT deployed there. As regards VVPAT counting, the same pilot phase, one randomly selected polling station slips to be counted, will apply here. Then photographs of the candidates will also be available on the ballot, which will be affixed to the electronic voting machine so that every voter can see. This information is very important for the voters, and the Commission would like that through you it reaches all the voters of Karnataka. Then electronically transmitted postal ballot, as notified in 2017, will be available to all service voters and all voters who are serving in Indian missions abroad. Final publication of service voter rolls has been done on 31st January in Karnataka, and continuous updation is on. Then affidavits. As you may be aware, that according to judgment of 13th September by Supreme Court, 13th September 2013, it is obligatory for the returning officer to check whether the information required is fully furnished by the candidate at the time of filing of affidavit with the nomination paper, and it should have all the details of antecedents of all the cases, criminal cases where charges have been framed. Then additional affidavit for no dues. This is in pursuance of Delhi High Court's order in Krishak Bharat versus Union of India, that for parliament and the state legislature, an affidavit needs to be filed with no dues so that it is clear that all the utilities, if government accommodation was occupied by the candidate, the no dues certificate is there. Then certain changes have been brought in forms and affidavit in Form 26, which are already there on the Commission's website and have been informed to all the CEOs to be brought to the notice of all the prospective candidates. Now, Model Code of Conduct. As you may be aware, that from the day of announcement, immediately, Model Code of Conduct comes into effect immediately. From now onwards, all the provisions will apply to the whole of the state of Karnataka and will be applicable to all the candidates, political parties, the state government. The Model Code of Conduct shall also be applicable to the Union of India, Union Government, in so far as announcements, policy decisions pertaining to the state of Karnataka are concerned. Commission has taken certain community people-friendly measures like preventing public nuisance. Commission have instructed that eco-friendly substances must be used for all kind of campaign propaganda material, like use of plastics, polythenes, flaxes. All those things should not be there, because these are non-biodegradable and cause lot of environmental hazards. Similarly, use of loudspeakers also is regulated to ensure that people can sleep in night, that it cannot be used between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. and also not in the vicinity of certain institutions, especially educational institutions, and where people gather together for important deliberations, hospitals, etc. Law and order. This is very important because Karnataka elections have seen certain offenses in the past elections, and therefore Commission has decided to deploy adequate central armed police force to maintain law and order, to have area domination, to ensure that people refrain from indulging in any kind of violence or any kind of breaking of law.
It will be तो एबीपी न्यूज पर बड़ी कवरेज, आज की बड़ी खबर में बड़ी कवरेज जारी है। और हम आपको बता दें कि 12 मई को चुनाव हो सकते हैं, इस बात का ऐलान बीजेपी के आईटी हेड अमित मालवीय ने किया है। वो हवाला एक न्यूज चैनल का दे रहे हैं हालांकि, और 18 मई को नतीजे आएंगे। हालांकि अब तक चुनाव आयोग ने औपचारिक तौर पर यह ऐलान नहीं किया।
ये है एबीपी न्यूज, आपको रखे आगे।